Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam
Waalaikumsalam
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Oke.
Ya, good day everyone. Salam sejahtera. Semoga semua sehat selalu ya. Oke, continue about the project management ya. So last we have develop the network between activities. So I will share. So can you see the slide? Okay, this is the the network of example yeah, and Milwaukee paper manufacturing. So the active there connection yeah between activities A, B, C to H, yeah, and then we have put all of the activities characteristic, yeah, execution time, yeah, and the earlier start, earlier finish, and lately start, lately finish. So in this project, yeah, we have we can finish to 15 weeks, yeah. 15 weeks, and from this, yeah, network between activities in this project and Milwaukee paper, so we can calculate the slack time. The slack time means that the activity stop, I mean already finished and waiting for another process, on the next process. So the slack time can be calculated from yeah, can be from LS minus ES, yeah, latest start minus early start, or latest finish minus early finish. Yeah, so this is the slack time before process the next process. Yeah, or the next activity. So we can have a computation of the slack time, the activity A to activity H. Yeah. So we can see from the this one. So in activity A, the slack time, yeah, 0 minus 0 or 2 minus 2. So this is the slack time 0. Activity B, slack time 1 minus 0, yeah, or 4 minus 3. So this is 1 week, yeah, the slack time 1 week. And activity C is 0, yeah, slack time. Activity E, 0 as well. Activity D, 1 week. Activity G, 0. Activity F, 6 weeks. Yeah, this is 6 weeks. And then we can have the completion of the project in 15 weeks. Yeah. So this we have understood how to fill this all of this. Yeah. First we fill with the forward. Yeah. From the early start, early finish, etc. Until the finish, and then we return. to be a tag word, yeah, when we want to fill the early, sorry, latest start or latest finish. Yeah. So this is the last network, yeah, between activities, yeah, in this project. Then we can have we can calculate the slack time. So we have the slack time here, yeah, in F and D and B, yeah. So the activity that having no slack time, so then we can determine as a critical. So the activity is critical. So we can determine the critical activity from this is A is critical, C critical, E critical, G critical, H critical. So we have this A, C, E, G, H. Yeah. So this is the path. We have the many path to finish to the H activity. But we have one, yeah, A, C, F, H. We have A, C, E, G, H, yeah, etc. So we B, D, G, H. Then we can see here and the critical activity then forming the network in as a critical path. So this is a A, C, E, G, H is a critical path because there is no slack time. Yeah, so this is the critical path. It's very important, yeah, in order to see whether we can simulate and we can change, yeah, this critical path into the we can reduce, yeah, the activity. How to reduce the activity? Yeah, I mean the time to finish, yeah, the activity. For example, in A, we have 2 weeks to finish, and then the C, 2 weeks to finish, yeah, E, 4 weeks to finish, etc. So in this critical part, yeah, it's very important to determine why. So we can make, for example, because we have the slack time in other activity like F and D and B. So if we change, yeah, the activity time, yeah, in one activity, so may change. Yeah. Yes.
Maaf ganggu. Ada orang nak join?
So the important, yeah, in this the project finish, yeah, time, so we can make a shorter if we can change, yeah, in the important, yeah, activity at the critical path, we can shorten the activity time, yeah. So how can we change, yeah, the activity times to be more shortened? So in the beginning of the last discussion and in the last class, we discussed when we have so many project, yeah, in the organization, yeah, many project, project 1, 2, 3. Extra, and using the similar or same kind of tools or machine, so then we can use if the there is the slack time in that activity. Yes.
Ada orang nak join?
Okay, so we can use if another project, other project in the time, the same time, but the other project idle time, no use the equipment, so that we can use this project can use the equipment in another project. So especially the critical activity like A, C, E, G, so we can shorten the project by using or finish the activity using the another equipment in another project. So in this case, so we call as a crushing project, a crushing project. So then when we do the crushing, meaning that using the another equipment and another project, so then we can shorten the activity time. Yeah, we can shorten the activity time, and of course, because this is the critical path. When we shorten the time in the critical path, will affect to the project completion. Project completion, for example, this in the normal condition, so we can finish 15 weeks in 15 weeks. But if we can shorten the project, the activity time on the activity in one activity, so that we can shorten the project completion. Okay. In this. Crushing project. The crushing project should be considered when the cost is also available. I mean, it's not too much, so we should calculate the cost. For example, activity A, if A needs the crushing project, so we calculate what is the cost. If C also want to have a crushing project, so we should calculate the cost. So what's the cost actually? Because we know that the activity has a own characteristic, and the characteristic of the activity will cost the specific cost. For example, activity A need to transfer to another project, if crossing needed, it's not too far, for example, very close, the equipment will be used, this will be cheaper, compared if activity that need for the to transfer the product, or alpha finished product to another equipment is too far, so this is will be the cost will be high, or maybe need additional operator, for example. So this also maybe more expensive. So this we can consider first. If we have cheaper, then we should we can choose the activity to reduce to experience the crushing, and we use another equipment and other project to finish the activity and be earlier, for example. So this is the so-called crushing project, so then we can shorten the project completion. On the other hand, the number here, put the number, for example, completion time of each activity, actually it's not the number is not fixed, and actual, because we know that this activity, is a probabilistic, as a statistic event, it's not fixed, we use it because we do the operator, operator also maybe having the different, concentrations, so then will the product also will be finishing the product, and a certain activity is a part of the probability, it's not fixed. So then we can have what is the optimist, optimist, a certain activity can be completed, or the pessimistic, activity can be completed. So this is part of the probability. If such a happen, then we calculate or we analyze using the probability and statistic. So we have and we know that the probability statistic, so we determine the mean value or the average value, and then we calculate the standard deviation. And then the we can we cannot say the fix, or we cannot say the completion of the project at a certain time, but this is part of the probability. For example, can be, for example, and the project can be completed less than 16 days, something like that. Because we do not know whether we completed on 15 days or 14 days or 13 days or others, or 15.5, for example. So this is the part of the probability and the statistic. However, if we have the fixed time, the better, like in this case, for example, we have already, this is fixed time, the activity time, for example, to complete a certain activity, and A is 2 weeks, C 2 weeks, E 4 weeks, G 5 weeks, for example. Then we will be easily, if we want to crush the activity to other project, that to the other equipment, so then we get the shorten, project completion, easily, so this is not more complicated, but this it's very easy, to analyze and to make the analysis of the project. Let's see what happens if we have some kind of crushing project. This is the slack time, just now we have to explain. So activity A, C, E, G, H, there is no slack time. So this is as a critical, on critical path. So this activity is on critical path. A, C, E, G, H. So if we want to put into the Gantt chart, so we can put the slack time, the slack time. The activity, into the Gantt chart, so we can put the earlier start and earlier finish, of this project, or we can have later start and later finish, so will be clearly seen, in this Gantt chart. So how many weeks or in which weeks, the activity can be started. For example, activity D can be started after or the latest start of this activity is in the fifth week, yeah. As well as activity E is the fifth week, so we can start, etc. So this is that what we have discussed, that the variability and activity time, yeah, this is part of the probability. So if it's the activity time have the variability. So the variability of the activity time can be classified into three estimate times. The first optimistic time, yeah. The optimistic time means the shortest time. Yeah. The pessimistic time is the longest time, and the most likely time is the most realistic estimation of the activity time. So usually this is already from the long period of the operation of the project, yeah, in the similar project, so that we can determine such kind of variability time, yeah, whether the optimistic, pessimistic, and the normal time. And then from the variability and activity time, so we can determine the expected activity time using this equation, or the variance, and we can determine the variance of activity completion time, yeah, with this equation. So the distribution of the activity times can be plotted, and then we can determine, yeah, what is a A, what is a M, what is a B. Yeah. So this is actually such a similar project, yeah, has been experienced by the organization or the company for many times. So then we can plot, yeah, for example, what is the optimistic time, for example, activity A, for example, yeah, that 2 weeks, yeah, normally, yeah, or most likely, and then actually can be finished optimist 1 week, for example, or pessimist to complete 3 weeks, for example. So this is the variability and activity time. It's not fixed, yeah. But the most likely, if we, for example, if we have we have a data, yeah, we have data, for example, mostly 2 weeks, 2 weeks, 2 weeks, 3 times, for example, and 1 week, 1 times, and then 3 weeks, for example, 1 time. So did that. The distribution will be most likely in the 2 weeks, yeah, because 3 times. So this is then we have the such kind of a distribution of the activity times. Then we analyze into the using the probability and statistic. Okay. So this is by analyzing the data from the experience. Doing this similar project in the past, so then we can get the optimistic time for activity A is 1 week, and then most likely 2 weeks, and then pessimist 3 weeks. Yeah. Then we can determine what is the expected time and what is the variance, yeah, during the equation. So this is the probabilistic of the activity times. Yeah. So that we can compute the variance. So this from the project variance, so we can determine the standard deviation. Yeah, standard deviation. Yeah, in this project, for example, yeah, from a project variance is determined from the critical path. Yeah. Critical activity is this is A, C. Yeah, E, G, H. Yeah. So this is the project variance, the summation of all of this variance of critical activity. Yeah. A, C-E-G-H ya. Jadi itu ya. Kaji sure, ya. A C E G H. Yeah, so this is the variance, yeah, summation of the critical activity variant. So then from that we can determine the standard deviation. Yeah. Because the critical path is the shortest time that we can complete the project. So then from the critical path, so we can determine project variance and the standard deviation. So the standard deviation is 1.76. Meaning that if we can complete the completion F 15, then we can have the project can be completed, yeah, 15 with plus minus 1.76. So if we can determine this the probability of the project completion, so that we can inform to the customer, yeah, to the customer, don't say we can finish 15 weeks. Maybe it's not wise because maybe can be something happen. Yeah, because this is a 15 week plus 1.76. So meaning that can be 16 weeks. Yeah, more. So then all we can say the optimistic, so can be completed less than 16 weeks. Then we can during the project running, yeah, the running of the project, so we can see which one the critical part, and during the project running, which activity that can be crushed. Yeah. So the crushing activity, we can select or we can carry, yeah, the crushing activity. Then we can hope that we can finish the project, yeah, earlier. Then what we tell to the customer. So also we can say the project can complete between less than 16 weeks. This is also part of the probability. Yeah, we are not fixed. So this we can have a probability to finish less than 16 weeks. Yeah, we can have 71.5%. So about 70%. So the project can be finished, yeah, can be completed, yeah, before 16 weeks from the probability statistic calculation. So now let's analyze, yeah, what is the crashing, yeah, of the project. If the crashing of the project happened, then what is the what happened with the completion of the project? Yeah? Is there any changing on, and how many weeks, for example, the finish of the project can be possible? So as we discussed just now, that the crashing of the activities can be carried out when we consider that the cost is available. I mean, the cost is a minimum as possible, and then the impact that we can shorten the project. Yeah. So if the cost is too expensive, maybe we should consider that we should not to shorten the project, yeah, because if we shorten the project and then the cost is high, and that is not feasible, the project, yeah, so there will be reducing the which is like the revenue. Okay. So how to compute the crash cost per time period? This comparison is the crash cost per time period. Yeah. For example, activity time at different rate, the 2 weeks, 3 weeks, or 4 weeks, or 6 weeks. So then we should compare. Yeah. So we should compare what is the crash cost per week, for example. So then we can calculate the crash cost. Yeah, crash cost per week, and then we can calculate by this equation. So again, the crashing project can be carried out to the activities at the critical path. So this is the crashing project cost per week. For example, the activity A, we have 750, yeah, dollar, for example, for B. B is 2,000 extra, yeah, and so especially in the critical path, yeah, activity, so like A, C, E, G, H. This is how to calculate the crashing project cost per week. Yeah? So this is and let's see when we do the critical. We do the project crashing. Yeah? The project crashing should be carried out from the critical activity. Yeah, so we have the critical activity. Yeah, A, C, E, G, H. So from the calculation, so we can see that the A is the chips cost. Yeah, when we do the critical, we do the crashing. Yeah. From this, then we can see, for example, A can be finished or can be completed for only 1 week, for example. Yeah, so then we can change crashing activity A 1 week. Yeah, so this we can have for 1 week for the activity, yeah, completion of the activity, activity time, and then we have the earlier finish. Latest finish is same, yeah, 1 week, after 1 week, and then the weekend FO, this is one as well, yeah, start earlier, this we do for the earlier start first, yeah, and then earlier finish, yeah, and then we can have go for this activity E also will change, yeah, the earlier finish. So the G as well, the earlier finish, and then H as well. Yeah. Earlier start and earlier finish will be affected. So and before we have a crash project, yeah, and activity A, so we have a completion of the project in 15 days, and then after we have a crash project of activity A, so we can reduce the into the 14. Yeah. Just now, when we do for the backward, yeah, to fill the earlier finish and latest finish and the latest start. Then it will change, yeah, in this case, yeah, from 13 to 12. Since it activity F, yeah, still have for slack time 7, yeah, just now 6 and 13, right? So then when we reduce into the 12, so it's not affect, yeah, the activity F is not be affected by the crashing. Yeah? Project. of activity A. As well as this path, yeah, BGGH. Since we have a new earlier start of activity H, then we can back to the latest finish of the activity G, yeah, from the 13, and just now, let's see, 13 into the 12. So then it will affect to the earlier latest start and for activity G and activity D, as well as activity D. So the latest start for activity B just now is 1, so then become 0. And then we can see as well the slack time before the activity A is crushed, crushing of the activity A into the 1 week. This is slack time, and the activity B is 1, as well as D is 1 week as well, G and 1 week as well. But now this become critical, the new critical. Okay, the new critical. Okay. Then from this, yeah, we have two critical paths now, ACEGH and BDGH. So there are two critical paths. Then now, is there any crushing? Yeah, more crushing that we can do. Yeah, see, the crushing project can be done for the activity then in the critical path. So we can see here, having passed by the two critical path. Yeah, the one is ACEGH and then BDGH. So then we can choose G. Yeah, we have passed by two critical path. Yeah, G as a critical path activity, critical activities for this path and second path. So the G we can just select, yeah, to possible to be crushed, yeah, to having the crushing project. So then if G is selected for the crushing project, then we can, for example, G can be completed, yeah, can be completed the activity into the 4 weeks, yeah, from 5 weeks to 4 weeks. So then we can have to the new earlier finish and latest finish, yeah, into the 11. But we still consider the activity F, yeah, have enough, yeah, the slack time from just now, yeah, before activity G is crushed, yeah, is a 12. So we next still 6 weeks, yeah, slack time. So then we can reduce it to the 11, and then activity H can be started, yeah, because the F can be start after 11, and G is a critical activity after 11. So then we can finish the project. The whole project can be finished 13 weeks. So this is the we can reduce by the crushing project of two activity, yeah, A and G in this case. So we can shorten the project into the 13 weeks. Yeah. So this is in the organization very important. Yeah. Because as I told you, and in the organization maybe the similar project, yeah, using the same equipment. Yeah, similar meaning that's not same. For example, in my case and past time, the purchase order for 20 inch of the diameter of a pipe. Yeah, another project is 36 inch diameter. Yeah, and another project maybe 15 inch diameter of the drilling pipe. So this is maybe a different project, but using the same machine or similar machine. Yeah, maybe if we have three machine for the three project, so that project A, project B, project G can do the crushing project. So the crushing project using the utilization of the machine, yeah, will be increased. Yeah, they will be optimal. Yeah, the machine is not under at the slack time. Yeah, in the idle time, so the machine not working. Then using the crushing project, so we can give the benefit to another project to be shorter. So then, by shortening the project, that will be important for the whole planning of the organization. If, for example, accepting a new order, for example, accepting a new order, then we can replan, yeah, of the project. So that by the project management from the planning, implementation, and the reporting, it is a cycle. So we anytime, so we can. We can change or we can revise, yeah, the plan. Yeah, so we can revise the plan. Yeah, then the we can execute the plan, and then we can again we control, and then we can do the crushing project. So this is every time. It's very dynamic. Yeah, so this is very dynamic and very if we have a organization having the many orders from the outside, then it's very important, yeah, the crushing project. Because if there is no order, yeah, there is no order, yeah, maybe no need to crush project because this costly as well. If we have the many order, the crushing project, so we can calculate what is the revenue, what is the profit, what is the cost, yeah, will be if we do a certain decision. Yeah, so this is the important. So the advantage of the project evaluation and review technique and the critical path method, especially useful when scheduling and controlling large project, yeah, the main project. Yeah. So for your I can tell you when I was in the organization of the oil and gas, yeah, manufacturing of the drilling pipe. Connector and then protector. So during in 1 year, so I can say I can have 10 project. So you can imagine the 10 project with the different time, can be 6 months, 2 months, or 2 years, 1 year. This is the project, yeah, time. So the then we can every time, so we can revise the plan. Yeah, anytime we revise the plan, and then we inform to the customer. Yeah, because quality plan. Yeah, before we execute, before we running the project, we should inform. We should have. We should get the approval. Yeah, from the customer, and then customer can visit in our workshop. Yeah, anytime. Yeah, that as a schedule. And then when there is the revision, there is the crushing project, then there will be, there is the revision. Then they also be informed to the customer. Yeah. So this is the important, if possible, yeah, in the beginning, we have the agreement to the customer. For example, yeah, if I can shorten 1 week, I can shorten 2 weeks. So what will happen? Can we get the benefit, for example, something like that. Yeah. So benefit can be, additional of charge, for example, if the shorten the charging to the customer. So the charging from the customer, so we can use as the cost of the crushing the project. So this is the advantage of the PRT or CPM. So this is straightforward. It's not a complex mathematics. Yeah, it's not a complex mathematics. Just now we have seen, right? Yeah. So So the critical path and the slack time analysis have pinpoint activities, which one that we should need closely to surveillance, yeah, the activity. Yeah. So in order to running smoothly, yeah, of the activity as a and the, at the end as the whole project. What is the limitation? Yeah, the project activity have to be clearly defined. Yeah, so if we have, for example, just now, yeah, if activity time is the probability, so we should clearly define. Yeah, what is the standard deviation? What is the main value of the activity time, etc. So then we can run, yeah, smoothly, and we can calculate. And we can plan, yeah, precisely. So this is another limitation. Yeah. So the number three is time estimate tend to be subjective, yeah, and are subject to fudging by manager. So yeah, so this manager is responsible for this the subjective estimation because this is probability statistic value. So then the we cannot have the fixed value, yeah. So this is the managers to the responsible from their experience and also that belief, yeah, trust, and then of course this trust is from the calculation as well, yeah, from the experience, yeah, especially. So the managers should decide whether this is crossing a project is needed or not, yeah. And then the manager, especially the operation manager, should think it's not only the this project but also another project as well as the purchase order, the new project that willing to come or is going to come or is going to be ordered by the customer. Okay. So this is the all of this project management. Yeah, I hope that this is a very important, yeah, for you later, yeah, even in the organization in any application. So the PRT or CPM, yeah, is important, yeah, in order to plan the project, yeah, to manage the project clearly, yeah. So then especially, of course, the big project, the many projects, yeah. If the short project does not, yeah, no need to, if we do not know the coming project or order project received by the organization, no need to press project, yeah, because this is costly. Okay, so this is all of this for today class. Any question? So hopefully this will be benefit for you. Any question? So for your information, yeah, maybe next week we have a quiz or individual assignment. Yeah, I will inform in the WhatsApp group. Okay. Any question? Just now, sister, what did you ask? Class lecture? What do you mean, class lecture? Oh, in the video, you mean? Okay, I will upload in the YouTube, yeah, for the last week. So who did not attend the class last time, they can see. Okay, if you have no any questions, so I end this class. Thank you for your attention today. Yes. Okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you, Dr.
Okay.
Thank you, Dr. Thank you, Dokter.